how powerful is our mind and what can we achieve only by using this is greatly shown by one of the greatest scientists in the world, Stephen Hawking, who was unable to move any part of his body except only one of his cheeks muscle. Is it possible to become a scientist even after being completely physically paralyzed? And that is also one of the greatest scientists of all time? That which even sounds impossible is actually made possible by Stephen Hawking. So let's see how this impossible became possible. On 8 January 1942, during the World War II, he was born in England in Oxford City. He was brilliant right from his childhood, but in his academic career he was mediocre. He was mainly interested to work with electronic devices. At a very little age, when a kid learns how to play video games on computer, Stephen built a whole computer by himself. And that's why his friends started to call him Einstein. His father was a medical researcher, so he wanted Stephen to make his career on the same field. But Stephen was not interested in that. At the age of 70, he was admitted to Oxford University. He wanted to do higher studies on mathematics, but at that time, there was no specialized course available on mathematics, so he had to continue with physics. After that, his interest in cosmology started to grow day by day. During his university days, he first noticed that he was not completely well. Because on the way to his university, it had happened many times that he fell down on the road without any reason. Or many times it had happened that suddenly he became unable to talk. In 1963, observing the decreasing condition of his health, Stephen's father took him to a doctor. After diagnosis, the doctor declared that Stephen had a never curable disease called motor neuron disease. In this disease, slowly every part of the human body became completely paralyzed. The doctor said he had maximum only 2 years left in his hand. Usually this type of diseases come to notice at the age of 50 years, but in case of Stephen, it was pretty early. So it gave the doctors an opportunity to slow down the process. When everything was seeming to be over soon, still he didn't give up. He continued in his scientific studies and researches. And within few years, he discovered the concept of black hole and Hawking radiation, which opened the door of a new scientific discovery for the whole world. Although his contribution to the scientific world was increasing day by day, but on the other hand, his different body parts were decreasing their functionality. After getting completely paralyzed, he had to take help of a wheelchair. A California-based company named WordPlus became able to connect a computer with his wheelchair. He was able to control a virtual keyboard on that computer screen with one of his cheeks muscle. Using that keyboard, he made up sentences, and then using a speech synthesizer, that sentence was spoken by a computer voice. Stephen said that he may never become successful in those complicated and time-consuming scientific discoveries unless he had that particular disease. Because it is also known from his ex-wife's interview that sometimes he used to sit on his wheelchair at a particular place, deeply thinking about some problem for even weeks long. He became completely unaware of what was going around him on those days. He didn't even talk to anybody. For this reason being also, he got divorced from his ex-wife. After that, he was married to one of his nurses. Being healthy, we don't dare to write a book, and being completely paralyzed, Stephen wrote a book on space-time named Brief History of Time, where he represented his scientific discoveries in a very easy and simple to understand language. And that's why the book was loved by the people from all over the world. Despite of his physical illness, he never felt shy to represent himself in different TV shows or even in movies. In some of the movies, he permitted the use of his computer voice for some comedy scenes also. If he wanted, he could use a handsome voice in his computer system, but he didn't do that, because he wanted that old voice to be remembered as a part of him. Once he threw a party for all the time travelers, but he announced the date on the next day. So as no one had come to his party, so he declared that there is no one who is a time traveler. Just like that, there are many interesting incidents linked with one of the greatest scientists of all time, Stephen Hawking's life story. This year on 14th March, due to his nervous system disease, he passed away. One of the interesting fact is that 14th March, on which date Stephen Hawking passed away, is the birth date of Albert Einstein, and 8 January, which is Stephen Hawking's birth date, is also the death anniversary of Galileo. At last, let us sum up what we can learn from Stephen Hawking's life story. Number 1, human's greatest power is the power of the mind. And number 2, if the desire is strong enough, then physical illness can never become a hindrance in the way of success. Like all the time, I would like to finish this video with one of my favorite quotes said by him. He said, the greatest enemy of knowledge is not ignorance, it is the illusion of knowledge. At last, a little request to you. If you find this video inspirational, then please share it with your friends, because by sharing, you can also help to inspire someone else. Next video is on the next Sunday. Thanks for watching. More wisdom, more solution, better life.